Welcome back to Dreamcatcher. Today we are going to prepare for KVPY. It's Kishore Vaijnanik Protsahan Yojana. 12 years solved papers from right 2009 to 2020. Right, now we are going to follow stream SX and it includes 5 practice sets. These are just introduction of the pages. And about the exam, we can talk about SX. The class 12 students aspiring to pursue undergraduate program such as BSc etc. with basic science, that is physics, chemistry, maths and biology, who passed class 10 with minimum 75% marks in mathematics and science, and the fellowship of students selected in SX will be activated only if they pursue undergraduate course in basic science, okay, and have secured a minimum of 60% marks in science subject in class 12th. Okay, those students who are intending or pursuing undergraduate program under distinct education scheme or correspondence course of any university are not eligible for this exam. And for to talk about the syllabus of the KVPY, there is no prescribed syllabus for KVPY aptitude test. It aims to assess the understanding and analytical ability of a student than his or her factual knowledge. However, questions are framed from the syllabus up to class 10th, 12th, first year of undergraduate course in basic science as applicable. There are 2 question papers in KVPY, one for the stream SA and other for SB or SX. The question paper is same for SB and SX, and we are preparing for SX today. And the question paper for SB or SX stream carries 120 questions for 160 marks. 120 questions for 160 marks. There are 2 parts in the question paper. Part 1, 20 questions of 1 mark for mathematics, physics, chemistry and biology, while part 2 has 10 questions of 2 marks each for mathematics, physics, chemistry and biology. Sometimes I might be using the abbreviations like PCMB for these subjects. And for the mode of exam, we are going to follow English, and the time of exam, okay, normally the notification for advertisement of KVPY appears in national newspapers. Yeah, even I came to know about this from the national newspaper. To talk about the fellowship, it's okay, like we'll leave those things. And the content, KVPY CSB OSX question paper 2020 to 2009. In the question paper 2020, 90, 80, all these are given with their respective page numbers. Okay, so the first question, then first we'll start with question paper from the year 2020, and the first few questions are from the max session. And I wanted you to fold. And I really prefer physics, chemistry and biology. So I'm not going into maths. So we'll go to physics part. And sometimes we might know the answers for these questions. So I am planning to read the question and then pause the video, drag to the answer part, then I'll go through that answers for you, so that I'm pausing the video and then going to the answer part, because I doesn't wanted to waste your time. So we'll go to the question without any delay. So the 21st question, the students A, B and C measure the length of the room using 25 meter long measuring tape of least count 0.5 centimeter. You have to take a book, just note down the values. So I'll go through the question once more. A students A, B and C, A then B and C measures the length of a room using 25 meter long measuring tape of least count 0.5 centimeter and the meter scale of least count 0.1 centimeter. Okay, a least count of 0.5 centimeter and a meter scale of least count 0.1 centimeter and a foot scale of least count 0.05 centimeter respectively. If the specific length of the room is 9.5 meter, then which of the following student will report the lowest relative error in the measured length? Okay, so here we have to learn the formula, that is relative error. Relative, note down this in your book, I'll give you enough time for that. So the relative error is equal to deviation in measurement, deviation in measurement divided by true measurement . So for student A, we know that the least count was 0.5 centimeter and we can convert it into 0.5 into 10 raised to minus 2 meters. And this was the deviation in measurement divided by the true measurement. The true measurement of the room was given in the question as 9.5. Right? 9.5 is equal to 0.0005. And the student B, we got it as 0.1 centimeter. It can be written as 0.1 into 10 raised to minus 2 divided by the true measurement is 1, so 1 into 10, okay. So the value will be 0.01. And for the student C, the scale should be used 31 times. Okay, the scale should be used 31 times. And R is equal to 0.05 divided by 30.48 into 31. So the answer would be 0.05. And you know, here the lowest relative error, whether it is 0.005 or the student B is 0.01 and student C is 0.05. So the answer is the measured value is for student A, which gives this, which gives the lowest relative error. Okay. So we got the answer as student A. And my second question, Meena applies the front brakes while riding on her bicycle along a flat road. The force that slows her bicycle is provided by the which tire? The force that slows her bicycle, whether it is front, it's front tire, rod, rear tire or the brakes. Yes, that was sure. The answer will be the road itself, because we learned about the frictional force which is used to slow down the bicycle, which is external force and hence provided by the road. The frictional force is used to slow down the bicycle. Okay, this is external force and hence provided by the road. Okay, the third question. A proton and an antiproton comes close to each other in vacuum such that the distance between them is 10 centimeter. Okay, a proton and an antiproton comes opposite, like come close to each other in a vacuum. The condition is in vacuum. So, consider the potential energy. Okay, the length is given as 10 centimeter. Consider the potential energy to be zero at infinity. Okay, then the velocity at this distance will be, what is the velocity? Okay, the question was to find the velocity. You have to know a formula that V is equal to root of kinetic energy's square divided by mR. It's a formula that we have to learn. What is that formula? V is equal to root of mv, ke square divided by mR. And we know that we have to read or to visualize that question once more. There was a proton and an antiproton, and they come close to each other, and the distance between them is 10 centimeter, and the kinetic energy the potential energy was zero. I think it was zero. Then what will be the velocity at that distance? Okay. So, from energy conservation, we know that potential energy plus the initial potential energy, the initial kinetic energy is equal to initial final potential energy plus final kinetic energy. Okay. So, the initial potential energy is zero and the kinetic energy ke square by r is equal to half mv square plus half mv square. Okay, half mv square plus half mv square, and v is equal to root of ke square divided by mr. What is that kinetic I thought that it was kinetic energy, but I think here we use k into e square, where k is taken as 9 into 10 raised to 9 into the value of electron is 1.6 into 10 raised to 9 minus 19, and the whole square divided by the value of m is 1.67 into 10 raised to minus 7, 27. Okay, 27 into what is the value of r? It's given in centimeter, and we have to change it into meter, that is 10 into 10 raised to minus 2. So by this we conclude the answer as 1.17 meter second. Okay, so formula is V is equal to root of the whole root of K into E square divided by MR. Okay, K is separate value, E is 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19, and divided by M is 1.67 into 10 raised to minus 27. Since we know that there's a proton and an antiproton. So proton again. Yeah. Okay, well, we will move to the next question. A point particle is acted upon a restoring force. Okay.